Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this amazing thing is one of the brand new Kramer Custom Graphic Collection Berettas. This is the Feral Cat. You may have already seen our video from down at Gibson's UK headquarters in London, where I check out four of the amazing new, besides these ones, Kramer Custom Graphic Collection. I check out the Hot Rod, the Danger Zone, the Viper, and the White Lotus, but there's actually six in the lineup. Five Berettas and 184, the Illusionist and this Feral Cat. And the links for the Gibson showroom video and the review of that are linked in the description box down below. But I'm here to talk about this beautifully spotted beast. Now, the Beretta came about in 1983, just after Mr. Edward Van Halen signed with Kramer and created the 5150, essentially what the 84 is now, without the slanted pickup and the big old headstock. And Kramer's deal with Eddie was you can't sell any Eddie guitars. You have to have like different variants of it. So the general public can't buy a 5150. Now you can with the 84, but you couldn't back then. The closest you could get back then was a Beretta with its beautiful slanted pickup. And the reason the pickup is slanted is because back in the day when Floyd Rose systems first came around, they had different string spacing to normal guitars and to regular humbucking pickups. So in order to get the poles under the strings themselves, you had to slant it, and that's the story behind that. The reason the Custom Graphic Collection came around was at the NAMM show in 2020, Kramer unveiled some beautiful new custom shop guitars, like $2,500 or $3,000 made in the USA numbers. Kramer are owned by Gibson, which is the best thing in the world, two of my favorite brands, and they're doing exactly what they should with the brand. They're putting them back to the forefront of the style of music they helped create. Brands like Charvel and Jackson and Schecter wouldn't be around if it wasn't for Kramer. So these were six custom shop hand-painted guitars, very expensive, and they all got sold off, but people really enjoyed the look. Like, because Kramers were all custom painted back in the day by like Dennis Klein, and you've seen the Snake Sabo and all of Mick Mars's guitars. So they brought back the custom graphics in the regular lineup. So these aren't expensive guitars, but they're the same same design than what's hand painted on those original ones, if that makes sense. All six of them. And spec wise, they're very close to the original, the regular lineup Beretta. Besides the fact that the originals were maple body, this is alder body. So Kramers in the 80s, the original Berettas were maple bodies till like 1985, 1986, and then they moved to alder. They're kind of inadvertently doing the same thing these days. So the original reissue Berettas were maple, now these ones are alder. So alder body in the classic Beretta shape, so like a kind of shrunken down, more super shreddy Strat shape. Beautiful bolt-on Kramer K-Speed profile maple neck. The lovely Beretta headstock, 12-inch radius maple fingerboard, 22 medium jumbo frets. You've got a Floyd Rose system, but I'll touch on that more in a second because it's got some very fun features. Seymour Duncan JB, slanted, as we all know, one volume with a push-pull, so when it's out you get more of a series, well, it's series parallel split to the pickup to give you more of a single coil tone. Now the Floyd Rose, a staple on any Kramer guitar, now features a D-Tuna. So this lovely little doodad on the back was created by Mr. Edward Van Halen in the 90s, because when you have a double locking tremolo, when it's all locked in place and you can't really tune it with the tuning pegs, you can't really go to drop D without getting your toolkit out and undoing the lock and then tuning it down that way and setting it up. With this little guy, it's as simple as this. So standard tuning. One of the greatest inventions to ever happen to the guitar. Another fun little feature is the fact that in the back, you can't see past that cover, there's a Floyd Rose trem block, so it only goes down the way, so you can't really bring it up at all. If any, you can't really anyways on these non-routed Floyds, but to stop any kind of wiggle room, there's a trem stop in the back to make it nice and secure. And I think, ladies and gents, that's all the specs on this bad lad. It comes with a lovely case. It comes with a Kramer case, so you're ready to rock right out the gates. I'm playing through a Marshall 1987X. Beautiful head, Marshall cab, not mic'd up. I'm using a two notes torpedo captor X to capture the sounds and also attenuate the Marshall. It's mint. Whether you're playing chords or individual notes or getting your tap on, this thing has a lot of tone and a lot of sustain. It's a very, very bitey guitar. Back in the day, there was kind of only single channel amplifiers. So one of the cool things they've done with the Kramer Barettas is add a treble bleed circuit into the volume control. So to get a clean sound back in the day, no clean channel, you're too busy rocking out with your massive hair and all that kind of jazz and your cowboy boots. You just turn the volume down on your guitar. And with the treble bleed, you keep that lovely high end instead of it getting too muffled. I'll quickly show you the series parallel thing as well. It's all single chord and kind of like in your face and really squawky. I had the urge to play it ever long, it just sounded really, really good. I I think, ladies and gents, that's all the specs, sights and sounds I can get from the beautiful Kramer Custom Graphic Collection Beretta, because my left hand is getting sore. It's been a long day playing lots of beautiful Kramers, and if you want to hear actually any riffs besides Everlong, get yourself to a PMT store and try one of these out for yourselves. Play some Van Halen, play some Bon Jovi, play some Motley Crue, and have the time of your life. Let me know down below in the comments which of these guitars is your favourite from the entire Kramer Custom Graphic Collection. I love the Hot Rod, but I really love the Illusion. This just harkens back to all of my favourite guitar players' guitars from the late 80s. It's an absolute sight to behold, and you'll certainly stand out of the crowd with it. There's also a toolkit on the back of the headstock that I always forget to mention. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on the Kramer Custom Graphic Collection, get your fine self to PMTonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.